Hello dear chess friends, this is Grandmaster Leonid Kritz for chessreactions.com. Today I will show you a crazy game of two crazy but very strong players, Levon Aronyan and Jan Nepomniachtchi. Absolutely crazy position. So let's start knight f3, knight f6, c4, c5, knight c3, d5, c takes d5, knight takes d5, e3. So this is basically, like, I assume black wanted to play Grünfeld, and Aronyan usually avoids the main lines. So knight takes c3, b takes c3. This doesn't look crazy at all. Not yet, so black plays g6. It's a normal idea to play bishop g7. And here Aronyan starts his play. He goes with h4. Obviously he wants to play h5, and to be honest, I don't know why black cannot respond with h5 and then play bishop g7 and just develop with b6, bishop b7, knight d7, wait with a castle maybe. It looks to me like allowing white to play h5 is not the best continuation here, but okay, so Nepomniachtchi played bishop g7, h5. And knight c6. So moves like bishop g4 with idea to force white to either take on g6 and exchange rooks, and basically white loses time for nothing, or play h6. This has a problem that I can play queen a4. So now if the bishop goes back, then I have queen b3, I'm developing and you are losing time. So knight c6 looks normal. Now maybe bishop g4 in the next move can be played. But white starts getting aggressive. Bishop a3. Queen a5. And rook h4. Absolutely unbelievable what's going on here. The bishop cannot be taken now. Because if you take on a3, you get rook a4. Queen b2, rook b1. And here I think the position after bishop takes c3, rook takes, bishop takes, queen c2, this must be very bad for black. I am getting the pawn on c5. So the bishop cannot be taken, and then white on his side wants to play rook a4, because now the pawn on c5 hangs. Okay, so black plays bishop d7. Now if white plays rook a4, then the queen goes back to c7, and you can see here the rook on a4 looks a little bit suspicious. I don't think white can take on c5 because of knight a5. The rook hangs and the bishop on c5. So, yeah, instead of rook a4, white plays queen b3, attacking the pawn on b7. Well, not immediately, queen takes b7 will not work still because of b8, but if, for example, black castles short, which he did in the game, then the pawn will hang. So black decides to castle, he wants to sacrifice. H takes g6, of course opening the h file is good for white. H takes g6 and queen takes b7. So it looks very dangerous because the king is in the center, there is no way white will be able to castle. But on the other side, what is good for white is that the pawn is on d2. And actually the king looks pretty safe, despite the fact that he has to stay in the center. So black plays rook fd8. Interesting lines would happen after queen takes a3. The white probably would take on d7. Now there is bishop takes c3. But then white has to move the rook, because after d takes c3, queen takes c3, black will take on a1 in the next move. Queen e2, king e2 for example, queen a1, if you take on c6, queen takes a2, I think white shouldn't be better here. But the problem is that white can simply play rook d1. And now both the knight on c6 and the bishop on c3 are hanging. And in addition, white has chances to attack on the king side. So knight e5, for example. This moves only like you have always to see what happens after rook a4, but here there is queen b2. But I think taking on a5, bishop takes e5, and now either queen takes e7 with advantage, or bishop c4, also with pretty dangerous attack on the king side. So it turns out that the black king is weaker than the white king, because the h-file is open. Okay, so... so black didn't take on a3. Instead he plays rook fd8. Now he wants to go with the second rook to b8. But white has queen a6. And this is, this moment I think Nepomniachtchi made a big mistake. He took on c3. And eventually he ended up in an endgame without a pawn. Instead of this, I think it would be better for him to keep the queens at any price and play queen c7. Even though he may lose a second pawn on c5. Still, because the white king is in the center, at least he has some counterplay. After bishop takes c3, queen takes a5, bishop takes a5, white takes on c5. And there is not much to catch in this position, because white has a healthy extra pawn. He is developed, the rook on h4 already participates in the game. So all he needs is just to develop the bishop from f1, and then start exchanging some pieces. Rook c8, for example, would be a mistake, because I have bishop a6, I'm winning time and developing. So black plays bishop e6, but this turns out to be not the best continuation either. So bishop b5. Now one of the problems is that after rook c8, white can take, black takes, and bishop takes e7. And now when the rook moves, then there is bishop f6. And eventually what the only way to protect against checkmate is to play rook d5, but then bishop f6, rook h5, take, take, I have two extra pawns, and I have knight d4 and knight takes e6. Completely won the position. So bishop e6, I guess at this point Nepomniachtchi got upset when he played bishop e6, because he realized that he ended up in a bad endgame. Otherwise it's difficult to explain this move. So knight e5, tactical tricks. If white takes, then bishop takes d2, queen e2, bishop c3, and then there is bishop d4. Bishop takes a1, bishop takes a1, and bishop takes a2. And here black might be slightly, well, actually, yeah, so bishop takes a2 is bad, because I have knight c6 and the rook h8, so I cannot take the pawn, but, yeah, so maybe I still have some chances, maybe I can play f6, knight takes g6, king f7, knight f4, and now bishop takes a2. Of course it doesn't look very good, but still at least something. So well, instead of knight e5, Arenian plays knight e4, and this is definitely a stronger move, because here there is no tactics at all. Rook d5, bishop e7, second pawn, plus it's again white who has a threat. I want to play bishop f6, king g7, and f4. And at this moment, I think we can say that the position of white is completely won. He has all his pieces developed. Nothing really hangs. The knight on d4 It's very strong. Black has to lose time. If he plays knight d7. f5. Bishop takes f5. Here, after bishop c6, black has a small surprise. He can take on d4. Now if you take on a8, black takes with a rook, and now he has some compensation, because the white king becomes weak. If on the other side you take on d4, then there is rook e8. And again, some tactical tricks are going on. So you want to avoid it at any price. So f5. Bishop takes f5. And bishop c6 now. What is the difference? The difference is that after rook takes d4, I have rook takes d4, and the position is won. And no compensation at all. So bishop c6, rook e5. Knight takes f5. G takes f5. Now I think everything wins. But after bishop a8, still rook takes e3, king d1, rook takes e7, still there is something to calculate here. But of course this position is must be easily won. But instead Aronian plays bishop g5. Was easy to calculate for him, I guess. Rook hangs on a8 and the knight on d7. Bishop g5, king g6. Bishop f4, now two rooks hang. Rook d8. So the idea again is after bishop takes e5, there is knight takes e5, and then the bishop hangs and I get the pawn on d2. And here black gets some compensation. So white shouldn't fall into all these traps. He plays simply bishop takes d7, rook c5, rook h6 check, so absolutely no chance for black, king g7, rook d6, bishop c7, and now rook c6. And black resigned. So a really interesting game with a crazy idea, this h4, h5, and then rook h4. But it looks like the position of white was pretty good. I don't think, however, that black played the optimal moves. I don't think queen a5 is the best move. Maybe b6 was better, but yeah, and even after rook h4, still this position was playable. It's just that Nepomniachtchi exchanged the queens and probably miscalculated something later on. Right, I hope you enjoyed this game. This is Leonid Kryts for chesslectures.com, signing out.